let me, on behalf of the government of St. Lucia, thank you for accepting this award. It is just a small token of our appreciation and our consideration for your contribution to the world. You are St. Lucian, incidentally, from my constituency, which gives me great pleasure. It's a pity you were never here to cast your vote. it's the very fact that you can show that you can come from a small island and make an impact on the world. I have been reading about you, reading about your achievements, and I feel very, very proud. I feel proud for many reasons. For reasons that you can offer, you can be an inspiration to people of St. Lucia. Not only young people, to the people of St. Lucia. It shows that regardless of where you're from, and there is a tendency now in our country to in a very subtle way to create a level of segmentation about where you're from. You understand? And a small country, that is not good, and I always fight against that. So it's nice that you can show that even though you're from St. Lucia, or you're from a part of St. Lucia that people believe is not the best part of St. Lucia, which I do not agree with. You can make an impact by education, by discipline, by hard work, and impact the world in the way you did. It's my government's policy moving forward that we are going to seek out people like you and let St. Lucians know, let our people know that there are people out there who can make, who have made contributions to the world, global citizens. And that's what I think you are. So I'm very happy that you have accepted our award. We're sorry it did not come earlier, but it's a policy of my government, as I said before, to seek people like you out. We hope that it's not too late for you to continue to make a contribution to the world, a contribution to St. Lucia. Because when you make a contribution to the world, indirectly make a contribution to St. Lucia. But we would appreciate if you could make a more direct contribution to St. Lucia. And when we meet later, we can discuss ways and means of doing it. But I want to tell you, it's a very proud moment for me. I want to thank Your Excellency to agreeing to have a separate ceremony for you because of your schedule. It shows the esteem and regard in which he holds and in which we hold you. I want to again congratulate you and thank you on behalf of the government of St. Lucia. And wish you all the best, you and your family, and thank you for coming. And I know it took some time from you to leave your schedule and be here. We appreciate that. Your family in St. Lucia, I'm sure, are very proud of you. I know Joan very well. I call him Dick Doe. He was a very good footballer. I understand you are the same. His skills are legendary in St. Lucia. And generally, it's a good St. Lucian family, a good St. Lucian story, which very proud of. Welcome. Hope we can chat again at some point. And thanks for accepting.
Thank you so much. May I just take this opportunity, first of all, to thank my family who are here. They are a great family. Dennis Laurencin, is my cousin. He is a physician. He has been an inspirational figure for our family, as one of the first physicians in our family. I remember visiting him at about 25 years ago in Wisconsin, where he was a physician, and he was known as the physician for Milwaukee, Wisconsin. His reputation was so strong, and I was so proud to be able to come for dinner that he hosted for me when I was a visiting professor at Marquette. And great opportunity to be able to have him here. My sister Joan Laurencin, who has been a stalwart in moving and keeping the family together, and also has been just a tremendous supporter for St. Lucia and for St. Lucian values, and really epitomizes the intelligent style and grace that I believe is really what St. Lucia is all about. And Marie Laurencin, who we've met all over the world, we've had these happenstance meetings all over the world. The last time we were in Wales together at a family site, and we met outside of the hotel by accident. Who has been just a great friend and has a family member, and has really worked to communicate with us over the years. And so it all comes full circle. And also I acknowledge the companions of the family members. Let me also just say, Governor General, how much I really appreciate you changing your entire schedule to make this event take place. I know you were so busy with a large number of responsibilities, but I and my wife were absolutely touched that you would you change your schedule to make this happen, and we are deeply grateful. And then finally, Prime Minister, let me just say that as I understood your popularity in St. Lucia, you didn't need me for my vote. You already had a landslide take place without me, and you can see in the time I've been here on this visit, there is an energy and there is an excitement about your leadership, even in terms of selections of people you have for positions. In terms of policies and procedures and ways of thinking, in terms of moving the country forward, there is already a positive buzz about your leadership. And so I congratulate you, and hopefully later today we'll have some time to speak. I also want to take the opportunity to thank my very good friend, Ambassador Dubois. I have known Ambassador Dubois for a number of years. I will make one small statement that may be embarrassing to him, but I will do it. I met him about 14 years ago. I met him. He actually came to my institute in Connecticut, and he had heard about me and knew about some of the work. And I still have it. He gave me a $10 bill, EC. And that $10 bill has the portrait of Queen Elizabeth on it. And I said, "You're giving it to me." He said, "Why are you giving it to me?" He said, "Because you must win the Nobel Prize for us in St. Lucia. And once you win the Nobel Prize for us, we will change. We will take her off and put you on." I still have that $10 bill, framed $10 bill, and it's actually at the entrance of my office to constantly remind me of this country, and constantly remind me of the work, and constantly remind me of my obligation. And so I think I said to him afterwards, "Yes, I'm going to work right now and work on this." So again, thank you so much, ministers. Thank you so much, Ambassador, family. Prime Minister and Governor General, thank you so much for the opportunity and the honor you've